Last half hour about the return of Wing Fest with some changes. For one, it's going to be at Highmark Stadium Labor Day weekend, with the Blue Jays possibly sticking around at Salem Field.
Yeah, for another, you'll have to buy a ticket this year ahead of time, and you'll get a 3-hour session. There will only be about 25,000 of those, about half the usual capacity for Wing Fest. And the reason? Wing King Drew Cerza told our Lauren Hall that the chicken shortage is to blame. It's been pumping up prices for months.
It's the same wings we've used in the past from Tyson, and you know, we're going to get allocations each week and save them all up. But that was not an easy task, and U.S. Foods worked really, really hard for us on that. They've been a great partner. That wing shortage is all over the country, and the cost of wings are double. And all I could secure, I felt, was enough for 25,000 people.
Can't do Wing Fest without the wings. So joining us live now is Jack Ampuja, Executive Director of the Supply Chain Center of Excellence at Niagara University. Thanks for coming back, Jack. It's good to see you.
Good to be with you, Kate and Michael.
So Jack, we have several questions about, you know, all these shortages that are still lingering around, but let's start with this one about chicken wings. We reached out to the National Chicken Council months ago when we first heard about this kind of chicken shortage, and they seemed to think that it was going to be, you know, a short-term thing. Well, here we are as we approach Wing Fest, getting this news now that this shortage is still having a big impact. I think people are wondering, why is this still the case? What's behind it? And how long do you think this is going to drag on?
Yeah. So let me give you two comments from the same source, Michael, the National Chicken Council. One, we've proven that the U.S. appetite for chicken wings is pandemic proof. It's a comfort food, so people were eating chicken wings at a very fast clip. In fact, chicken wing consumption in this country ticked up about 7% in the past year, which is a pretty strong number. And then number two, this one I find interesting. This is very tight supply, but not a shortage. That's the official National Chicken Council. So tight supply, but not a shortage. And yet it's a big enough news item that it's all around the country. And there are a number of reasons for it, that the COVID is underlying the whole issue. Number one, that chicken processing is still very much of a manual effort in the factory. You have people on the production line cutting carcasses to create the wings, the drumsticks, what have you. And number one, a lot of people got sick, didn't show up for work. Number two, because of guidelines from the federal government, the plants had to shut down for a while and accommodate cleaner workstations, putting up plastic shields between workers, fewer workers on the line. So basically, production capacity declined somewhat. We've still got a lot of people who are out. A lot of rural areas are not getting vaccinated, maybe getting unemployment money to be at home. So I don't think they've ever come back to full capacity with manning on the production line. And then the other thing that I think I had even spoken with the two of you about a few months ago was we had a very severe winter storm in the southern states, Texas in particular, which is a big chicken processing area. So everything shut down for a number of days, no electricity. If you remember, there were kind of rolling electricity shortages. Well, that means that we're not brooding chickens, we're not processing. Everything kind of fell behind the power curve, and we have just not been able to get things restored. I will also mention that, oh, maybe a month ago, if memory serves, we talked about the ransomware for the big meat processing company, JBS. JBS processes about 20% of the meat in this country, so they were only down for about 3 days, so not a crisis, but that's all come out of the production process. So the big thing is that chicken in total is down, consumption down about 3% year to year. Chicken wings are up about 7%. When you start to do the math, if you're processing less chicken, where are the chicken wings coming from? That's the basic issue. We have an imbalance.
Yeah, no doubt.
We have to leave it there tonight. Jack, thank you so much. Executive Director of the Supply Chain Center for Excellence at Niagara University. Thanks again for being here, Jack.
Thank you.
Yep, great to see you as always. I know people are glad Wing Fest is back, just
yes.
Not as many of us are going to be able to participate. So
That's
hopefully
right.
We have enough chicken wings for next year.
To make it home.
That's right. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you back here for another Town Hall tomorrow. In the meantime, you can send us a text to 716-849-2220.
And stay with us. Scott and Mary Alice are up next with Channel 2 News at 6.